one massive warehouse full of artillery, one mattress. Shipments coming, got half, we gon' match it. Pants looking like jet lags with dumb patches. Council meeting, blunt steaming and dumb ashes.
Guys, what is up? Welcome to another episode of Maximilian Must Know. Today I'm doing a quick take for you on one of Dua's newest fragrances. This one is called Holy Grail. And a couple of things before we actually talk about this fragrance. I got this one a couple weeks ago. I don't like to give full reviews of fragrances I haven't really been able to experience. So unless I've had a fragrance I've been able to wear it, 10 plus times, I'll give a quick take and then come back and give a full review. Any fragrance in my collection that I've given a quick take on, I will come back and do a full review on. And that's the same for this one, obviously. Second thing is Dua has done a lot of big things recently. I think there's a clear evolution of their company. Two things I really think that's great is they released a original fragrance called Flagship for the Summer, which I haven't checked out yet, but it's gotten a lot of positive response. I think it's a great idea for them to continue to release original scents and let people know that they can do that. And then they've been releasing a lot of crossover scents, a version of Aventus and Baccarat Rouge 540, which is just blown up. I think it's called Casino Elixir. And I actually was gonna try to get that, but by the time I tried, it was gone. They've released a bunch of like Aventus Virgin Island Water clones, Baccarat Rouge Virgin Island Water clones. So like these crossover scents that's different than anything out there. I think that's going to be a big thing for them moving forward. And that's not available anywhere else. And these are getting a lot of praise. So obviously not everyone's going to be a winner. But I think Massim knows what he's doing and can figure out which ones to do the right way. So I definitely will do one of those in the future. And if there's a Dua fragrance that you guys see out there and you want me to talk about, definitely leave a comment, let me know, and I will try to get a bottle of it and talk to you guys about it on camera. They definitely look out over there in terms of letting me review what I want. And I don't review everything. I review things that I feel like are going to be interesting to me and to you guys and aren't the status quo and sort of different scents that are unique and I feel like warrant perhaps a replication or a clone and or speak to me. And this is one that definitely did. You guys know the new Dua fragrances come in this packaging, and this one, guys, is Holy Grail. And I told them, when they do a metal label, I get excited because I feel like that means it's going to be a good scent from them. And when I saw this one, I was like, I gotta get myself one of these. This is their most expensive release, I believe. I could be wrong about that, but this is $105 for a 30 ml, so not cheap. And the reason why is this is inspired by Iris Grease, or L'Iris de Faf by Jacques Faf. And I'll read to you their description and you can sort of understand why they priced this one for them at an expensive level. 1946 spawned the birth of what is arguably the single greatest Iris fragrance ever composed. Since its creation, it's been adored by fans worldwide and continues to fascinate those with a penchant for the flowering plant that gives fragrance its name. Multiple perfumers have worked tirelessly to reconstruct Iris Grease by Jacques Faf, a perfume that has been long out of production. The winning formula is named L'Iris de Faf, and even the most renowned perfume critics have awarded it with their stamp of approval. We decided to take a step further and put our hand to the test of reconstructing the second generation of this masterful creation. We managed to do so in a way that natural ingredients are used and the price is brought down considerably. The original masterpiece sells for €1,470, so naturally there are many who will never have the luxury of owning a bottle. We wish for our fans to have a chance to experience the splendor of this Holy Grail Iris perfume, and now you can with a bottle of Holy Grail. As cheeky as a name is, it's perfectly captured our feelings towards the first-class composition. Natural Iris steers the composition toward a path populated with creamy peach and erotic rose. Oak moss provides a balancing effect along with elegant vetiver for a finish just as good as a start. Holy Grail is perfect for every season and only your most treasured moments. We can't wait for you to smell it. classified as a floral, and the notes Dua lists are peach, bergamot, petitgrain, neroli, iris absolute, orris butter, Turkish rose, jasmine absolute, carnation absolute, violet, violet leaf, oak moss absolute, musks, bourbon, vetiver, and sandalwood. Now, I feel like I can talk a little bit differently about fragrances sometimes because I am trying to learn how to become a perfumer. And so I have a lot of the tricks that perfumers will pull are bases that other companies make. Like IFF makes a lot of bases, Givaudan makes a lot of bases, Robert Ted makes a lot of natural bases. I have Givaudan's Orris base, I have a bunch of other iris bases, and you can be fooled into thinking that a fragrance is using natural iris or orris, when in fact it's just a base. And there's a lot of indie perfumers that do that. It's all good. Hey man, you know, get your bread however you want. But I just, you know, there's people who will not do a, which is funny, and then talk about how great this other scent is, even though they're clearly using a base. But anyway, that's neither here nor there. This is just a great iris scent. If you love iris, you will enjoy this fragrance. My belief, I could be wrong because bases are really good, but my belief here, guys, is that this contains real orris butter and some real iris naturals. I definitely believe that. This just smells, this is like iris on steroids. That's what this is. If you like iris, you'll like this. But don't think Dior Homme, because that's really, Dior Homme is sort of iris, and they're really trying to make iris masculine with Dior Homme. This is feminine or iris. This is just iris by itself. It's almost a solo flower, which is when you take one flower and you really sort of highlight that flower. You know, there's a lot of fragrances that do this. You know, Tea Rose, I think, is a really good rose solo flower. Durissimo by Christian Dior is Lily of the Valley solo flower. So there's a lot of fragrances that just highlight one material. And for me, this Jacques Fath Iris is really an iris solo flower. It's really highlighting iris, and then surrounding it with notes like peach, and some green notes like violet and oak moss that accentuate iris. But it's all about iris. And to me, this is all about iris. This is a love letter to iris. There's green notes here in this iris as well. Everything here is about iris. And when you spray this on, you might not think, oh, this is a very masculine iris scent, but you will say, oh shit, this is just iris on steroids. And that's what this is. This is iris on steroids. There's a lot else, other things going on here. There's obviously the peach, there's carnation, there's probably some rose. There's a lot of green things going on here. Carnation, violet, vetiver. But that's all in support of the iris and just making this iris stand out. It's a love letter to iris. It's not even a love letter. It's a declaration of, I want to fuck the shit out of you to iris. That's what Dua is saying here. That's what Jacques Fath was probably saying here. I haven't smelled the Jacques Fath. I'm probably never going to. Pardon me, that's the way it is when you live on Manhattan on Second Avenue. And I live in an amazing neighborhood, but there's still just sirens everywhere. It's as good as iris gets. To me, you know, my favorite iris fragrances are Dior Homme, Zerzhov's Iris, which is, you know, pretty expensive. It's a woman's fragrance. It's a little more feminine than this. Prada's Infusion, Infusion d'Homme, Fundamental by Rubini, La Tessa by Mask Milano, L'Herbe Bleue by Guerlain, which is soft, delicate iris. This is just straight iris in your face that'll get you through a full day with a lot of green shit in there to amp it up. I can't recommend this enough. If you love iris, you should pay the $100 to get this. I'll do a full review on it down the road when I've really had a chance to let it marinate, wear it a bunch of times, get a bunch of different opinions from other people. But I really enjoy this, and I think Dua did an excellent job with this one. And again, these are the type of scents I'm interested in. I will try to get a bottle of Flagship, talk about that one with you guys to let you know how I feel about an original creation. And I will try to get a bottle of the Aventus Baccarat Rouge crossover, because that just seems really interesting to me, right? And I don't love Baccarat Rouge, but I could see how what I don't like about it could be tempered by Aventus. right? I could see how in that could sort of soften Baccarat Rouge up and make it more wearable. I could see that just being the ultimate people pleaser, so I got to check that one out. But anyway, again, thank you to Dua for letting me check this out and for being accommodating. You know, they don't, again, like, they were fucking with me, you know, when I had even less than 5,000 subscribers. So they're, you know, I've dealt with a lot of people in this game, obviously. And, you know, Massim is just, to me, one of the realest, homeboyest, nicest dudes I've ever met in the fragrance community. And I'll always fuck with them. That's just me, you know. Even if one day I become a perfumer, hope he won't clone my, you know, do my shit, because I'll probably do it better for cheaper. But, you know, for now, I just fuck with them. And I, you know, great dude. And you obviously have the right to reserve your opinion, but so do I. And really great iris scent here. So a link to them in the description. If you have tried this, let me know. And let me know what else you want to see me talk about from them. If you're interested in seeing me talk about more from the Dua guys, definitely let me know. I know 10 minutes really isn't a quick take, but we'll have a full review down the road. That's it, guys. Thank you so much for watching this. I'll be back next week with more videos. You obviously know what it is.
See my seats, they Brazilian. I got speakers in the ceiling. I got sneakers by the thousand. Speak on how you feel. Look me in my eye and know you speaking to a villain, baby.